my career. But I'm this is my fourth year going now into my real estate career. And then basically I started real estate by accident. And I say that because before this, all I did was martial arts. I used to own four martial arts studios, and that's all I did my whole life since I was a little kid. I think since I was 8 years old. So I managed schools here in Orlando, and then just to grow my business, I had to expand. So I actually moved to North Carolina, and I lived there for 5 years. So from there, I opened up schools in Virginia, Texas, and I even went all the way to Sacramento. And because I was in the mindset of growing, but I didn't have any system, any nothing in place. So I end up spreading myself way too thin, and then I had to, slowly go back to 3-2-1 schools. And then I was losing the passion of martial arts because, I needed to survive with the business. So from doing martial arts, going from four schools to one, to selling all of them, moving across the seas to Barcelona, I was there. I wanted to restart a new life. Something went down in Barcelona. I couldn't stay, so I came back, and my wife signed me up in to do the real estate. So she's just like, I signed you up for real estate, go try it out, see if you like it. And then I did the class, like the Monday to Saturday class, for 8 hours a day. And then from there I took the test, I passed, and I still didn't do it right away. It was just there in my back pocket. So for like 3 months I just held it, and then finally January, no, April of 2020 is when I jumped the wagon, and I said, all right, I'm gonna do this full time, and I'm gonna see where it takes me. Because I knew if I started part time, it would have been tough for me. I just said, I gotta go all in. So since April 2020, I've been doing this full time.
And I want to say something. And Maria Dominguez goes, Rodrigo is a great mentor, friendly, and open teach. He loves being part of Orlando Lake Norman. It's very rare that we give, personally, I'm just going to give you another accolade in such a short time of how you turn, you're not turning around, but you just blew this downtown Orlando office as your branch manager. And we still haven't made the announcement official. I wanted to be in Orlando to do it, but I guess we could give a sneak peek. Rodrigo is now giving him, we're giving a partnership. Rodrigo in our Lake Nona office. We're gonna make that official. You guys heard it here first. So whoever's on this call, the 89 people, he's made it. He's partnered, and that's the hard work. We have admins that have become partners, and that's something that it's for Lifestyle. I know there's outside guests here, lenders or not, but it's one thing we take care of our own. Rodrigo, what I want to tell you is, I got a lot of people in this call. Let me call some of them out. All right. I'm gonna call some people out, but these are my friends. Wendy's good with it. Rice is good with it. Jeanette is horrible with it. Wendy doesn't do it. Gigi does it, but yeah, Gigi does it great. Lou Chaveri, I see him working out. He doesn't do well with it. I'm just calling a few more out. Lydia does it. Who else? Omi does it well. Even Nick does it well. How did you get over the fear, Rodrigo? And that way it gets people's attention that are listening. How did you get over the fear of turning the camera around, even when you weren't good at the business or new at it or doing good in other sides, to put your face and video and your personality with it? Because I could assure you, and what I love what you do in Orlando, you get a lot of people that probably wouldn't do it. I'll jump on a video. I probably wouldn't have done it before, but I've seen your results and I'll do it. How did you get over that fear, that hump of just saying, you know what, I don't care what society thinks, and not even about like how you were your upbringing. Let's talk about social media, right? Because you, Rodrigo, in person, same thing. He could be in front of 500 people, and I say, hey, Rodrigo, come on, break it down, and he'll do it because he has that nature in him. But when you did it on social media, something different. How do you get over that? What do you suggest?
So for me, it was just whenever I got to the point, even before when I moved to this country, it was all, this English was my second language. So I was at the beginning, I was just like very, I didn't want to speak to other people because I wasn't speaking the language correctly. And I still have my accent, it's fine. But, as I grew here and being here in Orlando for so many years, going to school, and I still, I was a little not shy, but I just didn't want to say much. And until one day it just kind of hit me. I said, you know what? I'm gonna just say it the way I've said it, and I'm, talking and I start just speaking. And then same thing with my videos. I'm doing it for myself. And whether one person or two, you know, or 200 people are watching it, I'm just going to do it. And I'm doing it mainly for me so I can continue growing and just kind of posting. And if you go back to the first video I ever did, it was the worst. And every time I go back and look at it, I was like, what was I thinking? You know, but it was just one of those that I posted and it's there. Right. And then I will do it and I will tell myself I had to do it at least once a day. Just post a video of me talking. And because I know that on social media, to get the attention for clients and people, they need to feel that you are a real person. So whether I post pictures and soul and just me there, and you know, it just wasn't doing much. But me just posting about, you know, I remember my first open house, and that's where the whole Dancing Realtor came, right? I just record myself. I was like, hey, my open house. I put a phone down. I started doing some dance. Come show me. This was when it was COVID, when nobody's doing open houses. I'm like, yo, this open house is lit. Everybody's here. And it was just me, right? But I would use those times just to practice, because I know that was the time for me to, you know, to get off my fear and just do it, you know? Like, you know, who cares if you get one like, or you get, you know, you want feedback. In the moment you realize that you can take feedback, then you won't really care what you post, and you know, you just get better by doing it, right? You won't do it perfect the first time, but if you stay consistent, you know for sure that you would improve every single time.
Something I share, Rodrigo, how many people, and this is what I know, like Wendy's like, I wish you could turn the camera on. I can tell you right now, and Rodrigo can confirm this, how many people have looked at a video after 24 hours right now? And some of your videos, yeah, they'll look at it and say, hey, that's awesome video came out to it today. Everybody's on stories. Nobody ever goes to Rodrigo like, hey, I remember 48 hours ago, your story of you dancing, you messed up, or your hair was messed up, or you had catch up. Oh, no, you're good today. But nobody's going to remember, guys, you in 25 hours. After 24 hours, that video would fade. But what they will remember is that, wow, that person's working it. That person was entertaining or empowerful and showed me something or showed me availability. How many people have ever came back to you and said, hey, your shirt was stained?
Zero.
It's something that I try to teach or preach, is that, guys, just post it. And you know, it's one thing, I don't know, I can't vouch for Rodrigo, but when I do my own videos and my own social media, I turn the camera on, don't relook at your video. Give us some tips on how to, like, get over that fear, what you did at the beginning, what tools you use. Do you rewatch your video like, oh my God, I didn't like this? Or you just
one shot? To be honest, I first, and this is something I did in the beginning, I used to do a lot, it was live videos on Facebook or Instagram, when you can't go back and, you know, re-edit it. I would just, because for me, what I noticed, whenever I tried to do like a perfect video, and if I record it and I see it, and then I go back and redo it, edit it, those are the ones that really doesn't reach out as too many people. Like, don't people really go, you know, they just think it's very scripted. But the ones that I actually messed up, and I, during my videos, I'm like, oh, wait, I don't know what I'm saying. And I just you know, just whatever it is, those videos got more attention than the ones that I try to make it perfect. So the moment I noticed that on my social media, I was like, you know what? Forget it. I'm just going to post. And if I mess up during my speech, because I, you know, the whole redoing it again, say, hey, it is what it is. You know, if I did pronounce it wrong, I redo it again, and just kind of during the video without cutting it, I just say it again. Like when I was doing walkthroughs, trying to do my YouTube videos, you know, I just didn't care anymore. I was just like, look, people are liking it. And then I'm going to dance to it too. You know, it's like kind of like, for me, every time I messed up, when I used to break dance or trip or whatever, like a trip or a stomp, if I stumble, I would just try to make up another move in the way. You know, I just got to, I needed to figure out something right away just to catch everybody's attention and not show that it was a mess up, or just make it fun. You know what I mean? So
I you get more buzz on those videos that like let's everybody see for a little bit. Let's pause right here. Let me share my screen and let's see some of my favorites. This was in our Lake Nona office. There we go. All right. That was a mess up. You made it. So much mess up, and everybody practicing. That was a good one. And then this was in our Now we're getting everybody into it. I love it. likes. Come on, man. Look how many comments. Let's see, which is one of my favorites. Hold on. I think I reported it in Orlando. Hold on. Let me go to my page. This is my favorite. Hold on. Let me see. I have it here. This was live. I recorded it. It was had to have been after this. Wait, hold on. Oh, here it goes. This is my favorite. Sorry for the side commentary. Was this exciting out there? look at me. Look, just look how much comments, and not even my video. I stole his thunder. 154 likes and comments for days. You know, talk to us, Rodrigo, on how much business this has brought you. It's all fun and games. It's great excitement. It's great to feel loved. It's great that you get engagement. How much business, real talk, brought, like brass tacks, what have you made through Instagram, Facebook? I don't know if you're on TikTok, but.
I am. And I try to keep it everything the same so everybody can kind of like, so for my Instagram, the Dancing Realtor, my TikTok is the Dancing Realtor, my Facebook is the Dancing Realtor, you know, just that way. Because the moment I noticed whenever it was like a niche for me and people were recognizing me for dancing, right, or just being me, right, it could be anything. They don't have to just be dancing or whatever. Just maybe something that you enjoy the most doing. Or whatever, whether it's cooking, dancing, singing, whatever it is. And you just kind of tap in that. And whenever I start noticing, oh, you the Dancing Realtor, right? And I start noticing that people are just kind of recognizing me. I just took off from there. And sure enough, I mean, the first text was like when I got a lead, a referral. I remember that one time. And then he asked me for my email, and my email was the Dancing Realtor. And he's like, wait a minute, are you the Dancing Realtor? I was like, yeah. Oh my God, I didn't know I was working with a celebrity, because, you know, just the name itself will always break the ice from clients, from agents, to anybody. It would just kind of do like a small talk. It's, oh, what kind of dance you do? Was it professionally? And I kid you not, oh, I used to DJ before. So it helps me right now on breaking the ice with every client I talk to. The shirts that I wear will say the Dancing Realtor. My business card will say the Dancing Realtor. And it's always a startup conversation. So as far as bringing me clients, I mean, I know the other day, Ciro said the same thing. I don't really keep track of that. But did it help? Absolutely, 100%. My social media has helped me tremendously because I constantly post. I'm consistent of what I post, and it's, and then when I don't dance, now people are expecting it, right? Like, hey, where's the dance? Why are you just posting just so? You know, and it's just something that, you know, you got to keep doing it. If you stay with something and just kind of keep doing it. And that helps me with how my first year of real estate, how basically my whole career started with what I was doing to get where I'm at right now, right? Because I didn't just have a bunch of friends sitting around that I can go circle prospect and start selling.
Let me put something there, Rodrigo. Listen, if it wasn't for your videos, you wouldn't be a partner of one of our offices. You wouldn't be a branch manager on our offices, and you wouldn't have like the people that you've inspired and made better. So, and not only sometimes you'll get points. Like in real estate, it's always about at the beginning for a lot of you guys, it's the financial part of it. Of course, you want to better your family, you want to provide better opportunities, you want to invest, you want to be, you know, financially set. And if you work hard enough and long enough, you'll get there. You'll get your first couple of Airbnbs, your rental properties. That's the ultimate goal. We never want you to just be a top producer for 5, 6, 7 years and never have something your own. Hey, I see you crushing it. I need you to open up a branch office. Hey, become a branch manager. What else do you want to do with it? But ultimately, even in real estate, not forget about opening an office, you want to have that legacy. But after a while, the money that you make in this business, the best part of real estate when it becomes like super passion is where the money doesn't change anything in your lives. It's just a benchmark of the month previously that you did. Damn, it was a good month. I made X dollars. Does it change anything in my life? Don't buy anything different. That's where you want to get to. At the beginning, I know it's different, guys. You gotta put your kids in school. You gotta pay for tuitions. You gotta pay for the roof over your head. You gotta pay for the first couple of properties you buy. You got to pay enough to pay your bills, the gas, the water, the food. But after a while, and I thank God for allowing me to get to that place, and a lot of people around me and a lot of the leaders and partners that you guys know of, you know, it just becomes a benchmark. And what I'll tell you, Rodrigo, what you don't know is biblically, the more people you've been inspiring and pushing people to be better, you've made that downtown Orlando office pop. I got to thank you for that. And that's why we wanted to give you that gesture. And you're going to make Lake Nona pop like that. And you're so giving of your time. If you're wondering why, when you came from that company with three letters, you're wondering why you have doubled your numbers in less than 6 months, is because you're helping so many people around you. It makes the business more fun. When you make these videos, what I want people to notice is, like, I know why you do this. It gives you that dopamine rush. It's great that I wake up in the morning and doing my funny videos, golfing, that you see people are really following your story. It inspires you to work for. So I just, maybe you don't know, but I want, you know, maybe you do know, of course. I want the others to know that you're not working your social media right correctly. It is so rewarding when you do it right. And it's so rewarding because when you think the moment you think nobody's watching, there's many people watching. And when you're not on your A game, sometimes you put people on their C game because they're like, man, if Rodrigo ain't putting a video today or in the last couple of weeks, you know what? I'm not going to do it either. You're inspiring people when you don't know Rodrigo. So I want to give you up to that. And I also want to let people on this call that people are watching, your friends, your family, your kids. They got to see you on your A game, even if you don't feel like it. Like, you know, some days on these calls, like, I love it because it makes me better to make sure you guys are doing better. And it's a circle. So, Rodrigo, I want to thank you for that, man. Like, you know, like, thank you. So, you know, Rodrigo.
No, I want to thank you guys. I want to thank you too, man. I know I don't think I say enough, but, you know, the moment, you know, when I met you guys and I took that leap of faith and just say, after being just 2 weeks with that other three-letter brokerage, I was just like, look, I think this is it. And sure enough, I mean, I felt it, I connected, and that's why I'm here and I'm not going anywhere.
Love it, mambo, love it. Mambo.
Ah, tú me dices, papi. Zumba.
Let them know it was that Rawway party, brother, signing that hand.
I was about to say that, Chris. Yes, the Rawway's grand opening. I remember you.
I forgot about that. It is.
Where's my revenue share? Where's my revenue share?
What about mine?
Yeah. Hey, that's what all started. That's it right there.
Wait, but listen, I also put my liver. But I smoked a couple cigars too. I had to close them. So I get part of my couple cigars with Rodrigo. But yeah, Jersey did set up the final close, and Sammy dunked it back like his final 4 days. Hey, love it, guys. Let's ask some questions. Whatever questions you have, like, raise your hand, ask the questions. Maybe what apps he uses. Rodrigo, yeah, that's a good question. I'm sure people have. Do you use any special apps when you do your video, or you just use the Instagram app and that's it?
No, I mean, the only ones I use for TikTok is the CutCap.
Okay.
I think that's cool. CupCat, yeah, something like that. CUT cap.
Oh, what is it? Talk. What is it?
Let me double check. I'll tell you. It's
CapCut.
CapCut.
Yeah, there you go. CapCut. Yeah. You see my accent.
What else? What other questions we got? Well, we're winding now. We got 5 minutes.
Yeah, it's true. Questions, yeah. Clients, just keep posting. That's one feedback I would tell everybody. Like, post all the time everywhere, because all those friends that you have that they forgot that you're an agent, they'll remember. I just got my listing like that recently, my new listing. A friend from high school, just kind of because I post, he's like, look, you know, he got, you know, I don't know what happened, but he decided to sell. He's like, you're the first person that popped in my story, and I the first person that thought it was you. I was like, you see, just because I'm consistent. Because you'll forget that he probably went with the guy that sold him the house before, but because I just came up and his story, he's like, yo, I see you killing it. You know, can you help me sell the house? I was like, absolutely.
All right, Rodrigo, a good question here. How often are you posting stories and how often are you posting feed?
Stories, I do it daily. I do it daily and I do it. I don't know if you guys go back, look at my Instagram. I do it a lot. Not so much, but I try to document everything I do because I want people to see what I'm doing, whether it's real estate, whether it's personal, whether it's just something, you know, small wins, whatever it is, I'm constantly putting on my story. But as far as posts, I try to stay no more than, you know, one every 2 days on my
posts. That's the key. That's the key, guys. And guys, let's do something. So Rodrigo took his time. He'll follow everybody back. Make sure to follow him on social. You're going to get like 40, 50, 60 people on your Instagram following you. Guys, I just put in the chat, follow Rodrigo. Follow them back, though, Rodrigo. They follow you, follow them back.
I follow everybody every time I get follows.
All right. So, Rodrigo, how often, a question, how often are you responding to people writing comments?
All the time, right away. Whether it's with an emoji, I like it and I respond with an emoji. You know, something that you always have to do. Don't let those and don't leave it unread. You know, and if it's something like a question, make sure you respond the question, you know. But if it's something like, yo, that was fire, I would just kind of put like, you know, an emoji, thank you. And it just, but I respond to every single comment, except for the ones that say promote your picture. I don't respond to those.
All right, man. Hey, Rodrigo, I want to
thank you. And another tip that you guys should do that I do a lot is I get the referrals agents from all the other, from my social media. I think I get more referrals from other agents outside of Florida than I do from like new clients. And just because they see me working, I have my pipeline of realtors from other brokerages that they constantly just, or even lenders are just like, yo, I see you working. It looks like you're a good fit for my client. And I'm just getting leads from that. So
I got a quick question though. Your funny videos and your videos, do you incorporate them as well in your emails, or do you leave your emails more on a business side and the videos for the social media, or do you incorporate them both in your email?
I don't post on my emails, you know, just like, see if I can post it here on the messages. Like I just have like my business cards, you know, it's not the typical sideways with the suit, just kind of being serious. It's more like a funny picture of me smiling and with the huge pool, the one picture we did in Miami. So I don't have videos on emails, but my signature is
funny. Different. That's what I was going to say. You're like very entertaining on social media, but then you'll get an email. So is it very serious or is it still fun in the email?
It doesn't match, right? So I try to, you know, because that's a great thing. You know, before I was doing all my social media the way I do it, and then my picture was like very serious, you know, like post. That's not me. So I'm like, look, I gotta match to who you're feeling. So that's, yeah, of course. So okay. It's not.
Thank you.
Any other questions for Rodrigo? Well, Rodrigo, you're the man, brother. Sorry I couldn't see you today. We had dinner planned. We had a whole full day for a lot of the upper. Again, let me down. Should have just went to MIA. He always treats me well. But Rodrigo, I'll see you next week with me, Irene, and Sammy, all Orlando agents, and I'm also going to be in Tampa as well. I'm going to spend 3 days. You know, I'm going to do two in Orlando, or one and a half in Orlando, and one and a half or two in Tampa. So love you guys. Have a beautiful day. Let's rock and roll. Post an Instagram story. Post a video. Follow Rodrigo. Let's rock and roll. Love you guys.
Let's go. Kill it.